Welcome back to SAP Developer News, your weekly news update with the latest on SAP products and developer tools.
Hey gang, happy new year. Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP devs. So ASUG, America's SAP users group, is offering quite a few developer webcasts in the next few months, focusing on ABAP topics. Our friend Tammy Pallas has posted a blog post this week where she shares the details of all of these developer webcasts. We have a ton of ABAP goodness here, folks, being presented by some pretty heavy hitters from the ABAP product management team. So you're getting the right information directly from the source. We've got several webcasts here dealing with RAP, the ABAP RESTful Application Programming Model. We've got ABAP Strategy, ABAP on BTP Roadmap, Building and Troubleshooting Fiori Apps, and much, much more. So check out Tammy's blog post for more information and make sure to join the ASUG Developer Webcast.
We've got some great news to start the year off with. SAP Graph is released and is no longer in beta. The original blog post has been updated. There's some updated documentation on the SAP Help portal, and you can start exploring with the new SAP Graph Navigator. If you want to get up to speed with SAP Graph, there are a number of episodes in a mini-series on our hands-on SAP Dev show on YouTube that you can go back and re-watch and catch up on. Check out the updated blog post, documentation, and start exploring SAP Graph with the Navigator.
The UI5 team recently introduced a new communication channel so they can reach out to you in case of important news, such as security patches or when they remove outdated versions from the CDN. Make sure to check out the blog post from Oliver Graf in the description below to get to the mailing list, and also check out the announcements functionality in the demo kits, and consider subscribing.
We're just back from a new year, and it's a great time to catch up on anything you might have missed from SAP TechEd back in November of the previous year. And one of the best ways to get caught up on SAP TechEd is to check out the SAP Integration and Extension Talk podcast. In episode 78, Cecilia and Rui, who were two of the hosts in Channel 1 at TechEd, do a great job of covering all the highlights, important announcements, and other great content from TechEd. So if you're looking for a place to sort of consolidate and catch up, this is a great podcast to do that. On a completely separate note, we also want to remind you that the SAP Developer Insights Survey is currently open. This is something that the Developer Relations team at SAP does annually to get insight and opinions from the community. And this helps us decide how to structure and what content to focus on for the coming year and how better to serve your needs. So we encourage you to check that out and fill out the survey when you have a few minutes.
SAP Community Calls are free webinars on specific topics hosted by the SAP community and open to all. We wanted to bring you some breaking news that there's an upcoming SAP Community Call on the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, CAP. To you and me. It's going to be on the 24th of February. Keep checking back to the SAP Community Call homepage for details on how to register.
The SAP BTP SDK for iOS team did move strong into the new year with several major release updates. The SDK got its 7.0 release with some great highlights like M1 support, cross-context SSO with OAuth, which allows you to onboard users easier into your app by using OAuth tokens from an established session of a desktop application. The color palette and typeface got an update as well, and app versioning was added to mobile services. The open source projects got new releases as well. The SAP Conversational AI SDK for iOS with version 2.0.1, Fiori Swift UI with 2.0, coming with new UI components like the KPI progress item or contact item, so you don't have to use UI view representable anymore. And finally, SAP Fiori for iOS AR with 2.0, including APIs for more control over your AR annotations. Of course, with great SDK updates, there comes great responsibility. I'm happy to tell you that both available SAP BTP SDK for iOS tutorial missions on developers.sap.com got an update to be compatible with the newest SDK version. So if you're interested in more details about the changes and the updated tutorial missions, we have all links down in the description of this video.